Hey guys, welcome back to Let's Play Dragon Ball Z Kakarot Part 4. Okay, last time we defeated Nappa, but Piccolo has been killed by Nappa. And Piccolo's dead, Kami's dead, and all the Dragon Balls are gone too. Now Goku came too late, and we defeated Nappa, and he got what he deserved for killing and Yamcha, Tien, Chaozu, and Piccolo. And now Vegeta had to kill him. And we also defeated Vegeta, and lost a spirit ball at him, but we spared his life. And we also got the recipe for Chi-Chi. And we went to Master Roshi's place, and we defeated the robots that launched used to attack everyone. And we also did one of the submissions too. So now we're gonna have to head to West City to meet up with Bulma. Alright. Super sick. Oh, we got some rare items. Wow. Cool. Probably need to talk to Master Roshi, right? Let's see what rewards do we get for his training. Fancy Urn. Mega Mass level 1. D-Metal, 2 Chicken. Beast Meat, 3. 3 Rice. 2 apples. If you finish any more of your training, come back and see me. I'll reward you for your efforts. Alright. Yes, sir. I'm gonna collect some more of these orbs. Right. But before we do that, I gotta customize the super attacks. My super attack. Change it to Super Masenko. That's for sure. Alright. Super attack skill tree. Crushing Strike. Super Recovery. Heavy Blow. Alright. Okay. Some items. Ah. Event. Still we got Chi-Chi's helmet. Worn by Chi-Chi when she was a child. Fitted with a keen, throwable blade. You can also discharge a powerful beam. That was Goku's girlfriend in the original Dragon Ball. Cool. Okay, I should... No, wrong button. Gotta get some... Let's see here. Development. When you see a wrench and a bolt, that's development. But enough about that right now. Focus. Oh, look. It's Cyborg Tao. Mercenary Tao. Heh. I can tell by the look on your face that you recognize how truly amazing my new attire is. I spent hours on its design, using only the finest materials in existence. Unfortunately, I'm carrying too much, and it's detracting from my appearance. Here, you can have this. Sacred Text of Martial Arts. Thank you. A third-rate assassin cares only for the job. A super first-rate assassin such as me knows a sense of fashion is just as important. Oh, I remember Mercenary Tao. I remember him from Dragon Ball. The dude who was hired, the Red Ribbon Army hired Mercenary Tao to go after Goku and look for the Dragon Ball. And he killed Bora in front of Upa and Goku. No, he killed Bora in front of Upa and Goku, which made Goku really mad. And he launched a Kamehameha on Tao, which didn't work on him. And he did a Dodon Ray on him to knock him unconscious. But the Kamehameha didn't damage Tao, but ruined his outfit. So he had to get his clothes fixed by the tailor. And Tao killed the tailor. Pretty messed up. And he went back to go look for the last Dragon Ball, right? And then Goku rescued Upa after he drank the sacred water that he got from Korin. Okay, gotta kill you. Mercenary Tao is voiced by Kent Williams, who does the voice of Dr. Gero, Supreme Kai, and Elder Kai. And he also did Super Janemba from the movie Fusion Reborn. Yeah, Janemba's the main villain. And remember Gogeta? The one with the fusion dance of Goku and Vegeta? And he finished off Janemba in the movie that Paikon fought against. And Janemba's force form is that of a yellow blob. Goodness, why does Janemba sound like a Pokemon when he goes, Janemba, Janemba? Okay, let's talk to him. Fruit tree location. Ta-da. Okay. Romantic apron. Gotta sell something. Oh, we got mango. Now we can head to East City, West City, to do a submission. Goku, severely wounded from his bout with Vegeta, begins his recovery. Meanwhile, Gohan and company set course for planet Namek, here to retrieve the Dragon Balls there and bring their friends back to life. In Interplanetary Preps, go find out what Bulma has to say. Oh, great. We're gonna do submission for Oolong. Oh my god, that annoying pig. Gohan, you're the guy I wanted to talk to. What's going on, Oolong? Okay, here's the thing. I just saw something really freaky. Freaky? I saw Yamcha's ghost in the city. Yamcha's ghost? Are you serious? Yeah, you think I'd lie about something like this? That ghost didn't just look like Yamcha. He was flirting with all sorts of babes, too. Oh, I see. Man, even as a ghost, he'd be more popular than me. Anyway, I never seen a ghost before, so I'm really freaking out here. So, go on, old buddy, old pal. Don't think you can see if it's really Yamcha's ghost?
Wulong says he saw Yamcha's ghost. Find out if he's just seeing things. The experience we get is 6028. D metal, one awesome book for grown-ups, one fancy earrings. Yamcha's alive. He's not even alive. Don't you worry, Wulong. I'll go check it out.
Seriously? Thanks, man. I saw him over the park. I saw him over by the park southeast of here. Just watch yourself, okay?
Let's go on. Find Yamcha's ghost.
I saw him in the park southeast up here. Go check it out, okay?
We gotta go check it out. Oh, look, it's Master Shen. Master Shen. Though he is voiced by Chuck Huber, did the voice of Hiei in Android 17. Oh, he did Hiei from Yu Yu Hakusho. But in the Dragon Ball series, he voices Emperor Pilaf, Master Shen. Oh, great, here we go.
Wait, is that really Yamcha?
Thank you very much for taking time to meet with me today.
I really had a great time. I don't know what it is, but there's something gentlemanly about you today.
I'm just doing the right thing. A man should always treat a beautiful lady with respect. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'll be leaving now.
He looks like Yamcha, right? But there's nothing really ghostly about him.
I guess I better follow him just to be sure. Looks like he headed over in that direction. Okay, as Gohan chased after Yamcha's ghost.
That doesn't look like Yamcha's ghost.
Let's talk to Master Shen.
Tao Pai Pai, you dolt! You aren't spreading the word about my beloved crane school. I need new recruits.
I failed to see the point in amassing worthless peons. Now that we'll have to have what it takes to be assassins.
We need students to train, you blockhead. Any hopefuls that show promise we can whip into shape. Plus, we need the money.
Okay, so you want to do things the hard way?
Oh, you there. Would you be so interested in joining the crane school? We're offering a special limited-time gift for new students.
Helade. This one does not have what it takes to be an assassin. Okay.
Why is there a hippo over there?
And a bear? Makes no sense how they turn into animals. Now why would Wulong be turned into a pig in the first place? Well, let's see what we got. Oh, rainbow orbs. Let's see if there are any more of these. Let's check first. Okay.
This means the real deal. I actually might not be able to finish this.
Talk to Yajirobe.
After watching those guys go at it, I was thinking I'd better do some training too. But I gotta eat before I do that. Can't train on an empty stomach. Time to eat. I'll eventually get in my training. You want some? I'm feeling generous right now.
Lean down on me. Thanks, man. You're such an awesome dude. Oh, remember Cooler's Revenge? One of Cooler's henchmen? The Cooler's Armored Squadron? One of the members include Dore. He's the green guy that resembles the Hulk, who was voiced by Mike McFarland. And let's see. Oh, remember Naze? He's that red guy. And he's voiced by Bill Tansley. And the commander of the Cooler's Armored Squadron is Salza. Though he has a French accent. Salza's voiced by Christopher Sabin in the video game, but in the movie is Michael Marco. Oh, Piccolo took care of these guys. He used a powerful blast on Dore. And also, that red electric wave tried to affect Piccolo, but it had no effect on him. So, he touched Naze with his own attack and killed him. I remember Cooler went into his final form. He thinks he found a third transformation state, but he found a fourth beyond it. And Goku went Super Saiyan on Cooler, and he launched a Kamehameha. Oh, I missed one. He launched a Kamehameha blast on Cooler onto his Death Ball attack, and he landed into the sun. Well, it didn't really kill him, but it gave him enough damage. But he survived in the next movie, Return of Cooler. And he uses the meta coolers just so they can attack Goku and all his friends. Oh yeah, in the end of Cooler's Revenge, Salza was shown surviving, and Piccolo killed him with a special beam cannon. It's pretty messed up and insane. Now we can head back. Okay, pick that up. I mean, what is your favorite Dragon Ball Z movie? I'd go with Broly, the legendary Super Saiyan. When Broly went berserk on Goku, and he calls him Kakarot. Yeah, Broly was voiced by Vic Mignogna in the movie, but later, Jiayoung Bosch, who did the voice of Ichigo from Bleach. Oh yeah, remember Paragus, Broly's father? He used that bracelet just to control Broly. Until when he went controlled Super Saiyan, it looked blue. When his control breaks in his normal Super Saiyan, and then legendary Super Saiyan, and he went berserk, just like Kale. And I remember Broly killed his father in a space pod and tossed him into that blue planet destroying ball thing. That's messed up. Don't kill your own father. Or just because they want to escape the explosion. And then in the end, Goku punched Broly in the abs really hard. Just to kill him. Well, he didn't really kill him. He was shown surviving. Alright. There we are. Oh, he's talking to a different girl this time.
You know, Yamcha, you're, I don't know, kind of boring now. You're all chilled out and stuff.
My apologies. I promise I'll be better next time if you give me another chance. Please go out with me again.
I guess I could. But seriously, if you're not more entertaining next time, we're done. Got it?
Oh, thank you so much. I'll practice some of my jokes for next time.
That's not what I meant by entertaining.
Oh, he just went off.
He looks and sounds like Yamcha, but he definitely doesn't talk like him. He's way too polite. He's heading over there now. It looks like he's about to leave town, but I should keep an eye on him a bit longer.
As Gohan chases after Yamcha's ghost again.
Do we get them all?
Nope.
Alright.
What? He's talking to another girl?
Hope you weren't waiting too long. My, you look lovely today.
Oh, listen to you. You seem to know how to flatter a woman now.
Oh, it's not flattery, my dear. It's the truth.
There you are, punk.
Oh.
So you're the piece of crap trying to make that move on my woman.
I'm sorry, you are...
He's my ex. He's turning into quite the stalker. Your ex?
Whoa, kind of reminded me of Ninja Murasaki from Dragon Ball when he stalks up to Dr. Flap. Looks like I gotta teach you not to mess with my woman.
Wipe the floor with this loser.
I was right. Yamcha really is a loser, is he? And he's got 3 pirate robots after him.
Wait a second. Can we settle the dispute like gentlemen?
Gentlemen? Man, shut the hell up and fight.
I can't fight.
Yeah, something's not right. I'm jumping in. Alright, we gotta fight with these annoying robots. Oh great, he's got an assist power-up robot dude over there. Come on. I didn't have full health. Watch out for the missiles. I think that super attack would help. Take that.
My machine! I can't believe you went out and called for help. You'll pay for this.
He just ran off.
Why does a child like that have so much strength? It's just not natural.
Thanks for your help, Gohan.
Huh?
Poir? I'm sorry for deceiving you.
I knew something was off. Why are you pretending to be Yamcha?
I was trying to make sure Yamcha's reputation with the ladies was in good standing for when he comes back. That's why you did this? But you knew you wouldn't be able to keep that up for long, right?
Poir! Poir! Ah, jeez, there you are. I've been looking all over for you.
Krillin! Oh, hey, Gohan. Were you looking for Poir, too?
Wait,
you were looking for me, too, Krillin?
Yeah, kinda. I need to give you a message from Yamcha.
A message from Yamcha? A message from Yamcha?
Yeah, he asked me to give you this message before the fight with the Saiyans.
Wow, flashback. Give it to me straight, Krillin. We've got no hope of getting out of this fight alive, do we?
Yamcha? Well, I'm not going down without a fight.
That's the spirit, Yamcha. You got Poir and Bulma waiting.
I'm in the prime of my life. Think of all the ladies who will miss me if I'm gone.
What are you talking about?
I've got a bunch of dates lined up with some girls I really hit it off with, so I can't disappoint them by dying. That's why if I survive the fight with Saiyans, I'm going to live my best life. And Poir's always got my back, too. I can't let my best friend down by not enjoying myself, right?
What?
Well, yeah, I've got something I want to say to Poir. If you know something happens to me...
Come on, Yamcha, don't get all gloomy on me.
Please, Krillin.
Alright, fine.
If I die, I know Poir's going to take it real hard and probably go wild trying to fill my shoes. You know, like trying to patch up things with all the girls I've dated. But I don't really care about that. Poir's done so much for me. If I'm gone, I want Poir to enjoy life, and even though I'm not around anymore. Will you tell that to Poir for me?
Yamcha?
Yeah, you got it. If it comes to that, I'll give Poir your message. But I don't think I'll have to, because we're going to win. Thanks, Krillin. You're a true blue friend.
True blue? That's an expression.
Yamcha! Oh, Yamcha!
Well, actually... There's more to the message.
There's more? Please tell me. What else did he say? What were their names again?
Pearl and Sapphire, I think. He did want you to try and patch things up with those girls, if you could. I mean, he was probably joking when he said that. I just thought I would give you the full message.
Yamcha had to go and ruin the whole thing with that last part.
Got it! Pearl and Sapphire, right? I'll do what I can. Things will be as right as rain by the time Yamcha's back. Hurry up and come back, Yamcha. I can't wait to see you.
Poir's got a heart of gold.
Yeah, no kidding. Poor managed to turn Yamcha's ridiculous story into something touching. Wow. Lag. So yeah, that's what happened. Wait, what? It was Poor and not Yamcha's ghost? Jeez, I was scared for nothing. Well, at least I can sleep easy now. Thanks, Gohan. I can tell Poor's going to be super happy to see Yamcha when he's back. We gotta do what we can to wish him back as soon as possible. Hurrah. Yamcha's alive is done. Yeah, over. We're just getting started, bro. Alright. Gonna collect some orbs right now. But before that, probably need to power up, level up. Let's count. How much experience do we have for Gohan? 6,622. In other words, I'm gonna use that sacred water, that ultimate sacred water that I'm gonna give. Use Ultimate Awakening Water for every characters. Extra juicy steam fun. Oh, gotta give him some more. It's silver. I was gonna dash. See if I can destroy 10 of these. Probably by dashing into them. Now where were we? Oh yeah. As I was saying, Broly did survive in the Dragon Ball Z movie. Broly returns. We're after Goten and Trunks and Gohan battled Broly. So Goku from other world did a family Kamehameha on Broly and destroyed him. Then took him to the sun. That's just crazy. Oh yeah, I forgot to mention the Dragon Ball Z movie 8. Where the Z fighters, including Trunks, Piccolo, Gohan, and Vegeta, had to share one of their energies to Goku, just so Goku could beat Broly. And Broly keeps beating up Goku senselessly, because he's too strong. Remember that Dragon Ball Z movie 9, Bojack Unbound? After Cell blew up King Kai's planet, and also that star to seal away Bojack and his minions, and he released him. Oh, Bojack, he was the main villain. There's Koku, Beto, Bujin,
and Zanya. Bojack just killed Zanya after Gohan went Super Saiyan 2 on these jerks, including Beedo and Bujin, with one kick. And Trunks fought Kogu, the one who works for Bojack, and he went full power, and his skin turns green. Bojack went full power, and his hair turns red, and his skin turns green, and he becomes more brutal and muscular. He needed a powerful Kamehameha, and Bojack and killed him. Too bad Bojack was pure evil, and a sadist. Oh, remember Lord Slug from Dragon Ball Z? The movie number 4? I remember. He's a super Namek. When he wished for the 7 Dragon Balls, he wished for eternal youth. And he tries to use that power to freeze Earth and destroy it. And Goku tried to beat Lord Slug, but he was too powerful. He went into false Super Saiyan. All he did was punch Lord Slug's arm off. And he was revealed that he was a Namekian. Yeah, if Goku can manage to pull a trick like he did to Piccolo by his dancing moves and affect his ears, Namekian ears. Well, Piccolo had no choice but to hide his ears. In other words, Gohan used that dancing technique just to distract Lord Slug, weakening him. And then when Goku launched a spirit bomb on Lord Slug, destroyed him along with this device. This cloud device. I mean, remember Lord Slug's henchmen, including Anjira and Metamacha? He's a life-draining henchman. And he summons the middies by draining lives out of victims. Goku destroyed Metamacha with the Kaioken attack. And he used that powerful Ki Blast by destroying the clones. And when Angela used the powerful blast out of his mouth, Goku deflected it and it landed into his mouth, killing him. And Goku, and remember Piccolo fought Wings? One of Lord Slug's henchmen did a powerful blast on him. Right, let's kill the Kawari man. Oh, remember Dragon Ball Z movie number 2? World's Strongest was with Dr. Wheelo, the main villain. His human form died of a frostbite, so now he's in his robotic form of a brain. And his right-hand man, Dr. Koshin, though he's an android. It was revealed that he was an android, a robot. And Bulma read so much about him. He also fought one of the Biomen. Goku fought the Biomen with the Kaioken attack and the powerful blast. When Dr. Wheeler was released, all he did was destroy the floor, and Dr. Koshin was electrocuted, revealing into his true robotic form. And I forgot to mention this to you, Dr. Koshin was voiced by Troy Baker, who also did the voice of Ginger, one of Garlic Jr.'s henchmen from the movie Dragon Ball Z, The Dead Zone. And he also did Hoi from The Wrath of the Dragon, the 13th movie of Dragon Ball Z, with Haruta Garn. And he did Dragon Fist onto Haruta Garn, destroying him because of Tapion. Remember Tapion? He's the one with the whistle, the ocarina. Still collecting more orbs right now. And Goku did a powerful
Kaioken Kamehameha to Dr. Willow, but it destroyed the castle, and he had and his shirt was torn off. And the Z fighters fight against Dr. Willow, except for Bulma and Roshi. And Goku had to use the energy, the spirit bomb, to destroy Willow for good. And he did the same thing to Turles. Oh, remember that 7th movie of Dragon Ball Z? Super Android 13? Come on. I'm gonna click more orbs. Please. As I was saying, remember the 7th movie of Dragon Ball Z? Super Android 13? Android 13 is the guy with a southern accent and trying to kill Goku. And the other guys, Android 14, he's the gray dude. And Android 15, the short dude with the short purple dude. And Trunks came from the future. I remember Vegeta did a decapitation punch on Android 15. And Trunks did a powerful slash attack, cutting Android 14 in half. I remember Android 13 absorbed one of 14 and 15's parts, and he went into his final form. Super Android 13, his skin turns blue and his hair turns red. And Goku and Vegeta went a powerful punch onto him, and it had no effect on him. And Android 13 did a SS Deadly Bomber onto him, causing Goku to lose his shirt. Then he did a spirit bomb. He was using a spirit bomb. He was charging his spirit bomb onto the sun just so he could finish off Android 13 and went Super Saiyan on him with a spirit bomb attack. He tried to punch Goku, and Goku punched him to finish him off. But enough about the Dragon Ball Z movies, let's just carry on. Just explaining to everybody about the Dragon Ball Z movies that I've seen. Well, for the most part. Seriously, need to go. Let's see here. Okay. Seriously, need to see Bulma right now. We're gonna need Hoverite, Molluscium, Thermiphyte. Need 3 parts for Bulma. While moving on the field, use LB to search your surroundings for key and detect where you can find materials and other items. The location of the items glow and the color of the glow indicates that what you can find there. Yellow, deer, wolves, and other animals. Fruit trees. Red, rare items. Purple, destroyable boxes, rocks, and other objects. Collect parts from the space pod. Look, there's a lighthouse. And a D-metal.
Let's battle these quarrymen. And the Cybermen. Get away. Didn't see that coming. Oh, look. What's under the water? Nothing but fish eggs. Got some D metal. Nice. Come on. Alright. I'll deal with that annoying enemy over there. Kick their butts. Oops. Nose was itching. Get away from me. You nuisance. Haha, level 18. There's that red stuff. Please don't distract me. I gotta battle you first. I still gotta collect the things that Bulma needs. On. There it is. No. Nope. Come on, please find them. Aha! Is that it? That's a D metal. Come on. Where exactly can I find those things? Where can I find these hoverites exactly? All right. Is this the one? Yep, that's one of them. Now two more. Come on. On my way. Oh, it's a fan. There we go. Come on, jump. Thermiphyte. Molluscium. Gotta find that. See if I can destroy some trees over there. I can see better. But first, let's see if I can. Come on. Oh, wait a minute. See if I can hunt those deers down. Boom. That's all of them. Deliver the parts to Bulma. Die, you obnoxious robots, piece of junk. Die, you scrap head. Gotcha. So then. Gotta get some items on the garden. Let's fish first. You've seen it already. Hurrah! Caught a fish. Big fish. Too bad we already caught that. Well then. Let's head back to Bulma. Talk to her. Handed over materials needed to Bulma. Hurrah! Soul emblem received from Bulma. You got development community leader Bulma and unlocked a new community board. In this community, you can activate community skills that help development. Build up this community if you're looking to increase your vehicle's levels and abilities, as well as reduce the cost of part development. Oh, the Ganyu Force. Christopher Sabat did the voice of Raccoon, Birder, and Jace. Okay, talk to Bulma whenever you're ready. Alright, let's talk to Dr. Briefs. Have you come to pay me a visit? Is there anything new in the world map? Nope. Nothing new. But, you might want to get some food, some sweet smorgasbord by collecting a lot of fruit. Goku, severely wounded from his bout with Vegeta, begins his recovery. Meanwhile, Gohan and Kakarot. Some fruit as much as you can, Gohan. The enemies do get stronger later. Okay. Look, rainbow orbs. goodness, another Red Ribbon Army base over there. I've got to take it down. Die. Got another base. Yeah, that does stop them, that's for sure. Root over there. Okay. Let's go somewhere else. Should go back to West City. Sell some stuff. Let's talk to the cook. You need to collect more peaches. The only thing I need to do, I gotta check my character, Gohan. The experience I need. Only 30,000? That's a lot! Getting started right now. Still gotta get more peaches and some cupcakes just so I could level up, get more experiences. Probably try it before we faced it to planet Namek. When we head to planet Namek. Only apples. Still gotta find some peaches. Yep, nothing but ripe peaches and stuff. Come on. Come on. What do I see? Whoa. Stop trying to distract me. Oh no. Earring for teen. Team metal. Apple. Let's just use our map first. going to Bulma's place and talk to her. Her spaceship's ready. Okay. Actually, let's do it. That's not enough experience. Wow, we're heading to planet Namek. We are. Gohan had his hair cut. Oh, it's Quee. And Vegeta escaped from the healing chamber, and Quee stopped him, and he had to run away from him. Yeah, that's Quee, one of Frieza's henchmen. His rival. Yakuya is voiced by Bill Townsley, who did the voice of Elder Toguro from Yu Yu Hakusho. And he also did the voice for, who did he voice? He also did Naze from Kuu's Revenge. He used to do Goldo, the Ginyu Force, in the original Z. Now Greg Ayers voiced him. Lag. Look at Frieza's henchmen attacking the Namekian village. Those aren't Saiyans. Those are Frieza's henchmen. Frieza Force soldiers. They blew up the spaceship. Now they're mad. Let's battle these jerks. Why do they dress up like Saiyans? Those Frieza Force officers are the tough ones that we gotta deal with. The commandos, they're pretty brutal. They block. Come on. Don't press the wrong button. Oh, support's not full enough. Come on. There we go. Level up. Oh no, Bulma's upset. There's Zarbon. He's the green one, and Dodoria's the pink fat guy, and there's Frieza. Frieza's voiced by Damon Mills, and this. Oh great. Now Kui is gonna battle Vegeta. And he's got his scouter back on. Let's see here. Find Kui and put him in his place. Vegeta versus Kui. Alright. I'm at a level 23rd right now. So then. There's going to be a lot of Namekian fishes out there. I should probably level up. One, two. Oh, those soldiers kind of look like a pool. Let's check my level, shall we? Okay. 90,000? That's a lot. Let's learn Supreme Power. Okay. Super Attack Pele. Meteor Hammer. Know How. Blow. Whoops. Supreme Power. First, look, one of the Frieza spaceships. All we gotta do is destroy it. It'll give us some items. Kaboom. Get sugary cupcake and silver compass. Stronger than these annoying enemies. Blow that thing up. Got some fruit gelatin and high quality carrots. Yeah, Damon Mills did the voice of, let's see here. Did the voice of Monaka from Dragon Ball Super. Yeah, I remember him. Really need to charge up my key right now. Wow. Fish, please, fish. He's got a fishing pole. Where did he get that fishing pole from? Namekian whitefish. Another one. Bam. Black Namekian fish. Is there a gold one? caught two fishes. Two types of fishes. Go over there. Yeah, crushing the clown is its top priority right now. Includes Kui. The clown he's referring to is Kui, right? So I can boost up my super attack. Alright, come on, here we go. Yeah. Got a D-metal. Does that look like the Uranus to you? The planet Uranus or Jupiter? Frieza Force officers. Okay. Yeah. Excuse me. Before that, let's see if I can get eat this sugary cupcake right now. No, I'd rather not. I'd rather use that power. I'll take this. Just to give Kui a taste of his own medicine. Alright then, let's do it. Still need to charge up my key. Oh. Let's fight those Commando Frieza Force. Yeah, they're worthless. Alright, Vegeta. Why are you destroying a lot of things? Those. And they even got a campfire. trees, huh? Those Namekian trees. Destroying a real lot of rubble there. What? There we are. This is where Vegeta powers up and destroys Kui Scouter and Zarbon Scouter. But Dodoria Scouter isn't broken too. From the Dragon Ball Z episode, Frieza Strikes. Oh, he's at a level 19. Oh, he thinks he has a great idea. He's trying to spare his life. Why would you say something that triggers people? We don't like that phrase, Vegeta. We prefer once again. Yeah, Vegeta is mad at Kui because he angered him once again. Skip that. Dirty fireworks. In the anime Dragon Ball Z episode, is that episode 48 where, no, what is it? Which episode is it? Alright, search Namek for a safe place to hide. Hide out on Namek. This is when Vegeta, in the anime of Dragon Ball Z, he goes, "See you in hell, Kui." Yep. But in this game, he is angry at Kui for pissing him off once again. You can't fly now. Okay, you can't dash, so that's why we gotta battle these annoying Frieza Force Super Commandos. And the Super Commandos are even worse. Though I'm not full, I'm not even leveled up. Solar flare those punks. Yeah. Kui was really foolish to fight Vegeta, wasn't he? And Vegeta punched Kui in the stomach, sent him flying. And blew him up with dirty fireworks. Now we gotta find a safe place to hide. Right there. Skip that. Is that Frieza? Wow, it is him. Oh, Goku's heading to Namek with Dr. Brief's giant spaceship. Now we're back to Namek. Frieza's horrible henchmen. Can't fly or fire key blasts while moving. Namek and Turmoil, lower your key and find out where the mysterious key is coming from. Let's see here. Can't breathe underwater. Let's see. It's your air meter. If it gets lower, it'll turn red for a little bit. Because if it runs out, you can't die instantly. But you'll be teleported out of the water. Well, come on. Okay, here we go. And there's Elder Mori and Dende and Cargo. Yeah, Dende is voiced by Maxi Whitehead, who does the voice of Alphonse from Fullmetal Alchemist Brotherhood. Saruman just killed a Namekian. Mori is voiced by Barry Yandel in this. Oh no. Elder Mori is giving the Dragon Balls to Frieza and his goons. Oh. This is where Gohan explodes and punches Dodoria after killing Mori and threatening Dende. Yeah, Dodoria is going to use a headbutt attack on you, and he's going to do a Dodoria blast on you. Yeah, Dodoria is voiced by John Swayze, who does the voice of Lord Death from Soul Eater. And he also does the voice for Hohenheim from Fullmetal Alchemist Brotherhood. Remember, Chris Forbes did the voice of Dodoria in the original Dragon Ball Z in Funimation. He also did Genbu. Yeah. Yep. You show that fatso who's boss. Okay. Now Krillin and Gohan pick Dende up, and Dodoria chases after them. Krillin did a solar flare on Dodoria, and he took him to a safe place to hide. Alright, sneaky Vegeta. Dodoria's on his own. Gushomu's boss. Okay, we're gonna play as Vegeta and fight Dodoria. I know Vegeta is one of my favorite characters. He's pretty awesome. Though he's a little bossy. And he's a bad-tempered Saiyan. He hates everyone. He does hate Goku. Because he keeps surpassing him all the time. Ah, oh, stupid recovery drones. Get out of my way, seriously. Oh, crud. Where's that recovery drone? He's right there. Okay, gotta collect some more orbs. Yay. Let's count how many more we got, shall we? Experience, that is. 106,401. Man, that is a heck of a lot of EXP. It's so much easier if I could do it later. Do some training later. Come on, collect some more orbs, please. Okay. Once I finish Dodoria and Zarbon, I'll end it. Zarbon's voiced by Christopher Sabat, but in Dragon Ball Z Kai and Ultimate Tenkaichi, he was voiced by J. Michael Tatum, who does the voice for Tenya Ida from My Hero Academia. Yeah, he's the guy with the glasses. Oh, I forgot to mention that John Swayze did All for One from My Hero Academia, one of the villains of the League of Villains. Eric Vail did Tomer Shigaraki from My Hero Academia. I met him in Anime Week in Atlanta the last 6 weeks ago. He also did Trunks, Future Trunks. Why do these Frieza Force Grunts look like Apool? Apool was voiced by Brandon Potter, who did the voice of Red Hair Shanks from One Piece. I remember Dodoria snapped Wooly's neck. Pretty brutal. He killed all the Namekians. Wooly destroyed all the scouters, so they don't find the Dragon Balls. Get out of my way, you annoying Frieza Force. Oh, you just kicked me. Come on, man. I love when Vegeta goes da 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 da. I can't believe Vegeta just called Kui pathetic. He was just a weakling. He tried to distract Vegeta into thinking it's Frieza, and he did an ultimate move on him, but he survived. Alright. I'm gonna beat Dodoria. He took his scouter off, tried to give it to Dodoria, but he destroyed it, which caused Dodoria to lose his temper. This is the part where he tells Vegeta about his past. Why planet Vegeta was destroyed by Frieza. And this is when Dodoria thought it was an asteroid that destroyed the planet Vegeta, but it was Frieza. It was a lie. This causes Vegeta to lose his temper. Get out of my way with your stupid head ram, dude. Oh, that crushing fist is seriously getting on my last nerves, man. Stop it. Stop that. Oh my god, he's got a maximum buster. Dodge that stuff. Whoa! Well, he keeps doing it multiple times. Seriously, stop it. And then he does a consecutive blast. Gotta charge up and use the Gallic gun. Whoa! I didn't see that coming. Come on, please. Take that, Todoroki. S rank for super. Yeah. Yep, that's what I'm talking about. I was right. And he did a powerful blow called Vanishing Blow on Todoroki, and it obliterated him, literally. After Vegeta powered up and scared him. And then, in the anime, he goes, I do this, not for my race, not for my family, but you thought you could make the Prince of Saiyans an employer to your youth, to your will. And then he goes, ah, Lord Frieza, and he runs, flies away, and he blasted Doria and obliterated him permanently. Now Gohan and Krillin met up with Bulma and Dende. Yeah. In the anime of Dragon Ball Z, in Funimation, he was voiced by Laura Bailey, who also did Kid Trunks in the anime, but now in this game is Alexis Tipton. It's pretty cool. Frieza's henchmen lay waste to a Namekian village. Gohan and Krillin are unable to save a young boy named Dende from the evildoers. Elsewhere, Vegeta begins his search for the Dragon Balls. Oh, I remember. Vegeta killed one of the Namekians. Oh, we're in King Kai's planet. Giving him... No, Goku's... It was... And he brought up with Yamcha, Chao Tsun Tien, and Piccolo. He's talking to Goku about Frieza. Goku explained to King Kai and the others what happened. And King Kai's warning Goku not to go anywhere near Frieza. Frieza is one of the most evil characters in Dragon Ball Z. He's the one who used the Saiyans as pawns. And Dodoria killed Borgos, Fasha, Shugish, and Tora, one of Bardock's comrades. And Bardock tried to fight Todoroki, but Todoroki did a powerful blast on Bardock. It blew away his scouter and broke some of his armor parts. And later, oh my god, Vegeta. Battle for the Dragon Ball. He killed one of the Namekians. Lag. Oh, remember, there's Grand Elder Guru. He's the one with the Namekian Dragon Balls. Vegeta hurled the Dragon Ball into the lake. He tossed it in the lake after killing the Namekians. Clash with Zarbon. Chances like this don't come often. Go pummel Zarbon. As I was saying, in the episode of Bardock went after Frieza, and Frieza used Death Ball onto Bardock, and it obliterated Bardock along with the planet Vegeta, and all the Saiyans were wiped out of existence. But the baby Kakarot went into Earth, and Gohan, Grandpa Gohan, named the baby Kakarot Goku. And the baby Goku liked the name. Alright. We're gonna go after Zarbon now. But first of all. Oh man. Probably need to find a place to rest. So I can restore my energy again. Oh look! The orbs are back! Come on, get to the campfire so that you can rest. You gotta either rest or eat a meal. I'd say rest. Seriously, do rest. Party HP and Ki have been completely restored. Nice. But first of all, I should probably eat a meal. High quality meat from a wild beast that boasts extraordinary flavor. Pure, unadulterated goodness. The select beast meat. Let's taste it. Yep. So I can boost up my stats and effects and kick Sarbon's butt. Huzzah. I think Zarbon is one of the gay characters in this Dragon Ball series. That was besides General Blue. Mercenary Tao killed General Blue with his tongue. How messed up is that? That move is called Pressure Point Attack. More. Seriously, this time. Well, I should probably click more orbs around. Before we do that, why don't we go use our items first? Maybe use sugary cupcake? Okay. Nope. There's no cook in there. Can't use any materials. But I can go to the community. Proud protein on Krillin. Nope. Actually, let's give it to King Kai. Should probably do that. What? Superpower protein would help. Right. not even enough. Nope. Nothing more. Nothing else. Actually, I should put something in, like Vegeta. Or Turtle. Let's use Turtle, so, for launch. Why don't we use launch for Tien? Come on. Switch the Chiaotzu. Okay. Battle experience percent 15. Man, that's a lot of ranking. Oh, I forgot to put Vegeta in there. I could put Pilaf. First, I gotta put Emperor Pilaf right here. Second of all, Shu. My and let's see here, Turtle. Oh, let's see, let's put no, wrong one. Let's use Vegeta. Let's put the turtle next to Shu. Here we go. Shu is a wolf or a dog. No. Let's put it over there. Put Nam over here. For now. Now let's get out of here. And teach Zarbon a lesson. Get out of my way, dude. I got 1,000. That's him. I remember Vegeta laughed at Zarbon. Oh, come on. I need to charge up my key, man. Frieza's goal is to get all the Dragon Balls so he can wish for immortality. Yeah, Bloody Dance really can slow you down. Watch out for Wild Blaster. Gallic Gun, please. Oh man, come on. Whoa. Come on, please don't hit me. Gotcha. Now charge up. Alright, use more consecutive energy blasts. Starting to get on my nerves. Gallic Gun. Yes. Get a lot of experience points. Man, we're all level 25. And this is the part where Zarbon transforms into a monster. And he knocks Vegeta unconscious. Hey, look! That's Nail. He's one of the Namekian warriors. And that's Guru, the leader of the Namekians. The Guru is voiced by Bill Jenkins. And Nail's voiced by Shun Schimmel as well. This is where Elder Guru heals Krillin. Huzzah! Got a lot of experience from Krillin. Nice! Bulma. She still has the Dragon Radar. There's a cooking machine and shopping machine from Bulma's capsule house. Find the hidden Dragon Balls, hunt for the Dragon Balls, that's for sure. And there's a food shop. Okay. Come on. Let's make a dish. Some loaded sesame dumplings. A heavy dumpling with a heavy dose of sesame. You'll need a separate stomach to make room for this. One needs high quality milk and high quality eggs for artsy cupcake. Oh man. It's like 30% EXP. That other yellow cupcake. Okay, but first of all, let's see if we can... There's five bases over there. Enemy base. Let's destroy all the enemy base first. I really don't have time to be collecting all the D-metals. Job go on. I gotta do this submission over there. I don't really have time to be destroying bases right now. Nor do I have time to deal with you stupid Frieza forces. That Frieza force guard is green. There are all types of color force guards. One's red, green, blue, or yellow. Kind of reminding me of Orlin, one of Frieza's henchmen. Got another Namekian over there. Who is that? Well, looky here. I found a little Namekian runt. You might know something about the Dragon Balls. You're coming with me. A Frieza's force soldier is tormenting a Namekian child. Beat the bully and save the kid. Victimize Namekian. Stop right there! Leave him alone! Who the hell are you? The Namekians have done nothing wrong. I won't let you treat them like this. We'll have to fight those punks. Picking on an innocent Namekian? That's unacceptable. Got a Frieza force corporal. And a scout. I look light brown. Ouch. Been stunned. On. You're safe now. Stay away! Huh? You're one of them, aren't you? Don't worry, I'm not. I don't believe you. Everyone in my village was killed by people from outer space. You came from outer space too, right? You're evil too, aren't you? Right. Kid's been through a lot, so he doesn't trust anyone, not from this planet. I'm really sorry I wanted to save your village, but I didn't get there fast enough. Huh? I'm here to help, I promise. Huh? Oh, are you hungry? Shut up. What's it to you? I can get you some food if you like. We only need to drink water. Wait, so Namekians only need water to survive? Now that I think about it, I never actually see Mr. Piccolo eat anything. Namekians don't eat anything, they only drink water. Hey, wait here for a sec, okay? Huh? Gohan gathered some clean water and brought it back. Here, drink this. You went to all that trouble? No, something's not right. You poisoned it, didn't you? It's not poisoned, it's just normal water. Whatever. Good, right?
Yeah. What's going on? Is something wrong? I can't drink water anymore. What happened? I don't know.
There must be something wrong with his body.
What about some fruit?
Fruit? I never had it before. I'll get you some. Wait here. There should be some fruit I can collect around here. Okay, as Gohan search for the Namekian fruit. There's gotta be a Namekian fruit over there somewhere. Let's count. Okay, there's one. D metal. Two of them. Stop lagging. There's no time for this. There. Okay, this should be enough. Time to head back to the kid. As Gohan bring the fruit back to the Namekian child. Here you are. Here, I brought you some fruit. Try some. No good?
No, it's not that. I never had fruit before, so I'm not sure how to eat it.
Oh yeah, that's right. Here, I'll show you. After Gohan shows the young Namekian how to peel the fruit, he takes his first bite. So what do you think? It's bitter. Oh, sorry. Guess I should have tasted it myself first. But I think I can eat it. I think I feel a little better now. This is all really new to me. I never felt a sensation like this before. Yeah, what's going on? Maybe Bulma will know something. Could you wait here for a little bit? There's something I need to check. I'll be right back. Go see what Bulma has to say, Gohan. You're back. Did you find any Dragon Balls? No, but there's something I wanted to talk to you about. I met this Namekian child a little while ago. And yeah, so I gave him some fruit instead. I see. Did you know what might be happening? Well, this is a guess. But all the stress he went through might have triggered an abnormalities in his head and body. So instead of his body absorbing nutrients from water, he has to get his nutrients from food like us. Really? So how do we fix that? No clue. That's outside my area of expertise. Gohan returned to the Namekian child. So that's what it is. That's what happened in my body. Don't worry. I'm sure your body will gradually go back to normal eventually. I feel bad. There's not more I can do, so I figure I'd bring you a little bit more fruit. Hopefully this can help you last a little while longer. Why are you being so kind to me? Because it's the right thing to do. The right thing to do? Yeah, if someone's in trouble, you should help them out, right? At least that's what we do on my planet. Haha, there are some really bad aliens out there, but I'm glad there are good ones like you. What's your name? I'm Gohan, and you are? My name is Nick. Gohan, things are really tough for me now, but knowing there are nice people like you out there makes this a little easier to take. I'll try to stay strong. Great. All I can do is help. Thanks, Gohan. We got 7,903 experience points, one D medal, and one Master Corrin plush. Corrin's the cat. Now let's go find the hidden Dragon Ball.
Search the surrounding area for the Dragon Balls. Hunt for the Dragon Balls still. There we go. That's the 4-star ball. One of Goku's favorite Dragon Ball. 6,983 EXP earned. Oh, Vegeta's in the healing chamber. And then he killed a pool. 70,958 EXP. Oh. Now Krillin has the Dragon Ball. And Zarbon's chasing after Vegeta. Chase after Krillin steals the Dragon Ball from him in Vegeta's rampage. On. Come on, collect some more orbs. First, I'll kill these punks. Ow. Stunned. Stay away from me. Charge up your key. Finish him off. Kaboom. Alright. Characters. Yeah, money will be what we got. Juice up your key, dude. One. Well, I can't. I'll just have to wait until my key is fully juiced up. Seriously, stay out of my way, you annoying monster. Come on. Oh, come on, I'm getting paralyzed by those stupid, annoying monsters of Frieza. Once. Gotcha. The tough Vegeta. He's like a dinosaur when he said the mighty. Yes, he did. Let's go. Yeah, Krillin made it with Bulma. Oh, great. Vegeta scared Bulma. Now he's gonna fight Zarbon. He just transformed again. And his voice got deeper. He's at a level 24, that's for sure. wild headbutt. He headbutts you. Yeah, he just knocked me back. The counter move. Come on. Come on, juice up that key, dude. Watch out for this shooting star arrow! Watch out for those red glowing spots. They're coming from the sky. Don't get hit. Whoa. He hit him in the back. Okay, finish him off. Boom. Yay, leveled up. He sends Zarbon into the water. Wow. Bulma's waiting for you. Head back to the hiding spot, Gohan. Alright. Alright, now Zarbon's dead. Oh, great. Vegeta has the Dragon Ball from Krillin. He thinks Gohan lied to Vegeta into thinking that it was a clock. Because it's not a clock. It's a dragon radar. Now Vegeta's mad because Gohan found Dragon Ball first. He's trying to head to the Bulma's capsule house. Oh wow. It's friggin' lag. Frieza's ace up his sleeve. The Ginyu Force. One of these goofy dudes that work for Frieza and they do their special poses. Head to the Grand Elder Guru's palace and unleash Gohan's latent power. Okay. I'll have to do that right now, but first... let's go destroy some bases for now. Make that three more. Get out of my way. Okay, what's next? Only two more left. I remember in Dragon Ball Raging Blast and Budokai Tenkaichi 3, any players who would use an ultimate move that based on blast. Oh, never mind. This is out of bounds right now. But come on, die. All I gotta do is stick with the mission right now, but okay. Okay, the coast is clear now. So for now, I'm gonna end the stream. Now that we've defeated Zarbon. Okay, everybody, I'm GabrielGaming5000K. Signing off, and I'll see you in the next video. And we'll do two submissions. And on the next video, that's what I was gonna say. Alright. Alright, everybody. That's it. Toodles. Means goodbye. Bye.